It's Steve and Laura time. Let's go. Steve, don't do it.
Vediamo un po', ma. Don't worry, be happy. Everything's gonna be
alright. He said, don't worry, be happy. Everything's gonna be alright. Oh my gosh, he's encouraging them along the way.
Hey, Max. You used to drive a blue Toyota, man?
Yeah, but what do you mean used to?
It's on fire, man.
Man. Look, Steve gonna do anything. I'll see how Laura hasn't figured out yet who this is. Steve's gonna do anything to sit be next to Laura.
Pretty lady. Not the pretty boy, and we be jamming.
What? He said, "Don't pretty boy, we be jamming." Steve is acting out right now. Oh my gosh.
That's enough.
He says bobby pin. Uh oh.
My car was not on fire.
Oh gosh.
Go home, Marco.
Calm down.
Yeah, Steve, just go home. They don't want you there, man. They don't want you there. Just go home.
My dreadlock ticket, please.
Laura's so irritated. But you know Laura likes Steve's attention. You know she likes Steve. Everybody else in there told him to leave but her. Just if y'all peep game on that. Everybody else but her.
Laura, my pig. Thanks for coming, Steve.
Mm-hmm. Oh, sorry I'm tardy, but I just got back from the optometrist. He dilated the old peeper, so things are a little foggy.
Mm. I hate when they do that. You know what I'm saying? They can't just do one. They got to do two, and you can't see nothing. Like Steve right now. Can't see nothing.
Hey, that in there, dude.
He can't see nothing.
Steve, I'm over here.
Yeah.
Sam, what time you're going
to he's still not looking at him.
I have some tickets to the Dave Koz concert, and I want you to go.
Oh, yes. And yes. 1,000 times, yes.
He's a little dancy there. 1,000 times, yes. Gotta get your groove on. Yeah.
Why, this is the greatest day of my life.
Uh-huh.
Well, Ted's coming, too.
Oh, bust your bubble.
Wow, ordinarily three's a crowd, but
it's not just the three of us.
Mm.
Ted's bringing his cousin Myra.
Laura. You don't know what you get yourself into, girl. Oh, gosh. Leave well enough alone sometimes. Leave well enough alone.
Ow. Wow. In some mountainous regions of the country, that sort of thing is...
Uh-huh, right. Yeah, right.
Oh.
Yeah.
Steve.
Oh, darling, what difference does it make? If 2 or 1,000 people tag along...
That boy can't see at all. He must have just got them dilated. He can't see nothing. Look at her.
So long as we're together. Have you been eating?
Yeah, help him out, Laura.
Listen, it's a double date. Mm-hmm. I'll be with Ted and you'll be with Myra.
Mm.
Ted told
Laura, again, you don't know what you're getting yourself into, Laura. Oh, if we could only go back, we could turn back time. Oh.
Tell Laura about you, and despite that, she's looking forward to meeting you.
She said, despite that.
Wait a minute.
Mm.
This is a transparent attempt to pawn me off on another woman.
It is, Steve.
Well, it ain't gonna work. Never in a million years.
Mm-hmm.
Please, Steve.
Okay.
She gets a little sweat, the little caress of the swipe. She got him. She got him. Laura always fitted. I'm trying to tell you, she's always fitted.
And these are for you, sweetums. And these are for what's her name?
Look at the flowers. So he got Laura a big bouquet. He got Myron look like he picked those out of somebody's yard on the way there.
Her name is Myra.
Yeah, well, you better write it on your face, because that's where I'll be looking.
Right.
Look, Steve, give the poor girl a chance. Who knows? You might even like her.
Ha! I'd be very surprised indeed.
Yeah.
Myra, this is Laura.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Hello.
Hey.
And this is your date, Steve Urkel.
Hello, Steve.
Hello. I'm sure you're aware that Myra was a seaport in ancient Lycia.
Oh, yes. And I'm sure that you're aware that Steve derives from the Greek, Stephanos, i.e. crown.
But of course.
What a cute little snort.
It's some action tonight. Oh, gosh, Steve. Look at him. Look at him. Look at him. Lord, you don't know what you're getting yourself into, though, girl. You don't know what you're getting yourself into. Comment section, they be going at Lord. You know what I'm saying? Be coming for her. And you know, and just kind of the unrighteous hate that some people have for her. You know, and I was really kind of just bothered by it. Perplexing to me, because like we loved. Like I said, the girls loved her, you know, the guys loved her in different ways, but nonetheless, we did, you know what I'm saying? So I just really didn't get it. And I'm going to tell you something I felt like the Lord said to me, and he said simply the word impact. So that's what I was thinking about with impact. You know, you look at somebody like Serena Williams, right? You have people that love her, and then you have people that literally hate her, but because of the impact. Like, so what I learned is, impact is based on the perception of the person, but the impact still remains the same. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, so this, like I said, you know, Michael Jordan goes to opposing arena, you know, boo, boo, boo. He goes to his home array. Yay, yay, yay. What happened? Michael Jordan's still the same Michael Jordan. He's still the greatest player, right? He still was the best player in the league. What changed? People's perception. His impact didn't change. It was people's perception. And that's what God showed me about, you know, like what it is when it comes to Laura. It's like, it's her impact. And some people are going to be yay Laura and some people are going to be nay Laura, but it doesn't change the fact that she has impact. Matter of fact, you know, when people go and talk in the ways that they do, it actually proves the impact. You know what I'm saying? So, and another thing that I would say too is people's perception and then how they're based on their perception, that it's a response that they have. And something else I'm gonna give y'all, look, I ain't trying to take y'all to church, but something else the Lord showed me here, you know, going to I think it's what, Titus 1:15. Just read the first part because this is all you need. It says, to the pure all things are pure, but to those who are corrupted and do not believe, nothing is pure. In fact, both their minds and conscience are corrupted. Which that scripture is basically saying, like, if your perception is jacked up, you're not going to be able to see good stuff anyway. You know what I'm saying? We saw the good, you know, in Lord. It's like I said before, with Lord, the Lord character does, and the Steve character does in a different way, which I'll explain that later. Lord exposes a lot of people's hearts. You know what I'm saying? And it reminded me of this one scripture. I think it's in Matthew 7. It's in Matthew 7, but it says, do not judge so that you will not be judged. For in the same way you judge, you will be judged by the same standard, by the same standard of measure, it will be measured to you. And it goes on to say, but what it's basically saying, you know, it starts off by saying, number one, you're judging somebody and you're going to be measured by the same way because you're probably doing the same thing. Then the scripture goes even further to say, why are you trying to get the speck out of somebody else's eye when you got a plank in your eye? Right. And that in a nutshell is half the people that go at Laura, because I'm just like, Laura, like, what has she done besides have kind of some in and outs with Steve? What has she done? She works hard. She's respectful. You know what I'm saying? She's positive. You know, like, what does she do? Right. And it's just because people are judging, and they're judging their own selves, you know, give you the basis just for the newbies. If you weren't around then, and maybe everybody's area is different. You know what I'm saying? My school and people that I was around and stuff like that. But basically what it was is, us girls, we admired her. We admired her fashion, everything. And guys wanted to date her and have her kids. I mean, plain and simple, that's pretty much what it was. You know what I'm saying? And so there's nobody on either end of the spectrum that was hating on her. us girls weren't hating on, the guys definitely were not hating on her. Trust that. You know, so it this is just, look, I've learned her impact is her impact. Whether you write this this comment about her, that comment about her, all you're doing is speaking to her impact. It was all love. So, you know, anyway, man, love God, love people. May God bless you. May God keep you.